I used to think that Planned Parenthood really wasn't a big deal. Like, I used to think they used to hang out, get out birth control or just condoms, and that I didn't really think that abortion was, like, a really big problem and not a lot of people were doing it. I went to the March for Life at the beginning of this year in January, and I was just going to go. I'm like, oh, I get to go out of school, get out of school. I get to go to Washington, D.C. I'm like, oh, this is great. But then it was so much more to me when I talked to people there, people that had abortions, people that couldn't have kids. Like, my sister, my stepsister Clara, she was going to abort her baby because she was in high school. But she didn't, and it was the best decision that she's probably ever made. The March for Life changed me and who I am as a person and how I view abortion. I believe that Planned Parenthood should be stopped. They should stop doing abortions. And it is seen as somewhere that you can just go get an abortion and get out of that responsibility. They say that they're not like controlling the population, that they are just keeping it low, keeping it safe to like a normal level. So, and it's saving money, so we don't have to pay for all these other kids, their education, food, money, WIC. About 426 out of 1,000 pregnancies are aborted, according to the U.S. National Library of Medicine. And Planned Parenthood aborts 579,000 babies every year. And by doing so, they think they are keeping the population under some sort of control. They believe it is a woman's choice because that baby can't think for itself, can't talk, can't walk, you can't see it. And it's just a clump of cells, the women don't have time for it, they don't have the money, or the guy just ran away and she doesn't have any help. And it can't, the baby can't make their own decisions, it can't do anything, so they think it's just okay to just get rid of it, nobody ever talks about it. I believe that they should not have that out because they made that choice, and getting pregnant unintentionally isn't a planned thing, so it shouldn't really be part of Planned Parenthood. And it's not a woman's choice. Like, that baby is a life. It's not a potential human being. It is a human being with potential. A study shows that after 8 weeks of women having an abortion, 55% expressed guilt. 44% expressed nervous disorders, 36% had sleep disorders, and 31% expressed regret, and 11% were on psychiatric drugs. I'm going to read to you a few quotes from the founder of Planned Parenthood. But for my view, I believe that there should be no more babies. An interview with John Parsons, 1947. Quote, we do not want the word to go out that we want to exterminate the Negro population, end quote. Letter to Dr. Clarence J. Gamble, December 10, 1942, page 2. In my view, that this is the reason why Planned Parenthood was founded, because they wanted to get rid of the black population. If you look at where all Planned Parenthoods are, they are in poor black neighborhoods, and I still believe that they are trying to get rid of that. The founder also created the American Code for Babies, and she wanted, basically, you would have to file a permit to get pregnant, to have kids, and if you weren't financially able to, then you couldn't have them. That was a long time ago, but this organization is still shady. A quote from Fox News. The laundry list of possible crimes is exhaustive. Legally profiting, the sale of aborted baby parts, covering up rape and child abuse, aiding sex traffickers, overbilling taxpayers by millions, and giving confidential information to vendors of other women. And this has been going on. This is still going on. It's still a big part, but you don't hear it in the news because a lot of political figures are involved in this. We need to understand that there is nothing planned about an abortion. They should not happen. If it's meant to be, it is meant to be. They deserve a life. They deserve a chance. Like, every one of you deserved a chance. We need to save these innocent lives and start making more steps and toward to getting rid of abortion and Planned Parenthood and defunding it. Thank you. funds, Planned Parenthood should go to help all these other kids and mothers that want to keep their babies and help fund more birth control. They want to do that. In sex education, I believe that should be still be a thing now, even though it's not in Indiana.
Do you believe that the Plan B contraception should not be a thing either?
What is a Plan B
contraception? Plan B, it's like you take it so you won't have a kid.
I believe that's fine.
I know you kind of went along like the lines that they're sending out funding for the abortion. Do you think that maybe they should turn around and use that funding against mothers that are choosing to keep the children that need the help? That they should give them a small portion of that funding just so they can get started and get
I think that all the money for abortion should go to mothers that want to keep their babies and to help them out.
Would you be okay if abortions were maybe shifted to hospitals and then they were just part of like a bill, part of your insurance, so it no longer was being funded by the government and something that women could maybe have
a
free offer?
I mean, it is a part of your insurance, even if you do go to Planned Parenthood, but I just don't think it should be a thing anywhere. But Planned Parenthood is the biggest provider of it. Like,
someone gets raped, do you think they should have to keep the kid?
I mean, that's a small percentage of that happening, but I don't think they should if they don't want to. But it's rare that with something like